Welcome to the session of Master Stroke. In this session, we are going to discuss about the classification of DI caselet. Classification of DI caselet is one of the challenges out of two challenges which is going to improve your DI performance. Mainly, to improve the DI performance, we have to take care of three parameters. Like one is sense of data handling, another is time, another is your accuracy. How to encounter these three parameters together? We have to tackle two challenges. First challenge is how to classify the DI caselet. DI caselet, almost all caselet based on certain mathematical concept or based on the data representation, first we'll try to categorize. After then, for every category or every type, we will develop the tools, mathematical tools and logical tools. Simply, I will tell it is a tools to take care of any level of questions. Then again, welcome to the Master Stroke. Now we are discussing about the classification of DI caselet, how to classify the DI caselet and why to classify the DI caselet. What are the other basis to classify the DI caselet and how almost all type of DI caselet will fall down in that category of classification. Then this you can say it is all type of DI caselet, and this is going to affect your DI and LR section. Just we'll try to understand classification of DI caselet is first and most important challenges out of two challenges. Once you are not able to categorize the DI caselet, I am 100% sure maybe you will prepare 1 year continuously for CAT, afterwards also in DI you will not feel confidence. What is the reason you will not feel confidence? Because maybe randomly you have solved 200 caselet or 300 caselets, but you are not sure which type of caselet how to solve. Maybe it is some immediate reaction based on the data or based on the concept. You are keep on hit and trial putting, and out of 4 questions you are making 2 or 3 correct. But you are not sure if next time also questions will come in exam, in your actual mock or actual exam, then you will able to solve, because you don't know this question you have solved based on these two challenges. Means we have categorized, and based on that categorization we have used the tools. Then these I am giving the enough confidence how to gain the confidence after solving the 50 or 60 caselets of DI randomly from any of the books or any of the content, or maybe paroliko.com. You will get the enough content to solve either in the form of test series or either in the form of conceptual classes. You will get enough practice DI caselet. That much itself you will gain enough momentum, enough confidence to tackle any kind of DI caselet, because both the parameter, all the parameters how to improve your DI performance will be taken care. Then here two questions are there: how to classify and why to classify. Then how to classify, discuss after 1 or 2 minutes. Why to classify? Because data and table handling will improve and time will reduce. Second is, what is DI? First thing, before starting how and why, generally we are trying to understand most basic thing, what is DI? DI is just combination of data and logic, but generally in DI, data will be more than logic. Means logic we have to apply little bit, data will be more. Means sense of data handling is more important compared to logic. But just you can say, if logic will involve more, it will become DI caselet itself. It will convert into a LR caselet, where data will be given less. You have to just put more logic. You have to take care of all kind of probable solutions, and based on that probable solution, what will be the best solution for a particular situation, that is called LR. Then here data will be more than logic, means you have to just understand how many type of data representation can be. If data representation are for a particular type, then which type of mathematical concept will be used to solve or to compare the data? Either maybe it is given in bar graph or pie diagram, or maybe it is given tabular format, or maybe it is given histogram or any of the things. Then data, this is one of the most important thing. Or now it is in this era, it is a data science only. Everywhere it is data and data. Whatever you are doing, you are creating the data. Your full body is a just byte by byte of data. It is just feeling by Google Baba. Google Baba is following you each and everything as a data follower. Means each and everything, whatever you want, whatever you do, or what you can do and what you will think in future, all the data will be captured. Earlier Google was a search engine, but now Google is not a search engine. I am just telling in different definition. Now Google has become your just follower, or you can say it is a just a holding of data, holder of the data. Now it is a not search engine. If you are not searching on the Google also, Google is capable to follow you. Because maybe you will use any of the website. Most of the website, whatever ads are running, that is that is based on the Google or that is run by Google, then Google, you cannot, you can say any of the, at any of the cost, you cannot go away from Google. Then this is the beauty of data, and based on the data, now so many sciences are developed, like data science, and based on the data science, decision sciences, so many things are developed and so many things are going to develop in future. Then you are handling the data based on the tables, graphs, mathematical concept with certain degree of logic. This is our main target or main thing for DI. Now DI lump sum, or you can say just in rough way, these three points are there. Point number one is data representation, point number two is mathematical concept, and point number three is logic. Means either DI will be based on the data representation plus logic, or maybe mathematical concept plus logic, or maybe data representation plus mathematical concept. Means any combination of these three will create a different set of DI caselet. Then how many type of combination, valid combination, that is for CAT syllabus, or that is applicable for your aptitude test of CAT, that we are going to discuss. Means how to classify. Our classification will be based on these three parameters: data representation, mathematical concept, and logic. Based on these three parameters, we will divide the DI in total 8 types. You can say total DI will be divided in 8 types, or you can say type 1 to type 8. All your 99.9% I written, because 100% I will write, then it will become mathematically wrong. Anything cannot be 100%, but almost 99.9%, meaning is it is 100% only. You can say practically it is 100% only. 0.1%, what will be 0.1%? Nothing. Means almost all caselet you will be able to categorize based on these T1 to T8 type. And once you are able to categorize, and just after reading 2 to 3 lines of data, whatever information provided, you are just reflex action in your brain is happening. Oh, it is T4 caselet, it is T5 caselet. Then immediately your brain will reply, T5, this is a list of tools. This only you have to use. How much beautiful, how much your reaction time and your response time is going to improve during the time, once you keep on seeing the videos on the YouTube or maybe paroliko.com, then how much you are going to improve your response time and reaction time and confidence level. That itself, that you can say it is a way beyond whatever you are there, it will be very, very beyond the expectation, because you are understanding what is the main crux of the DI. Main crux of DI, understanding or categorizing the DI caselet, and second, developing the tools for each and every type of caselet. Then almost 100% you can say DI caselet or questions will be covered under T1 to T8. Now what is the next challenge? Next challenge is to understand the tools for T1 to T8. What is T1? It is not a buzzword or any puzzle word. T1 is a type 1, just a short form I am telling T1. It is based on the DI caselet, based on the tables, graphs, diagrams, plots, and scales, whatever can fall down the representation of data in the form of tables, graphs, diagrams, and plots, that we can say it is a T1 type 1. Type 2, again, it will be based on sets and subset, and Venn diagram. To understand T1 in best way, first we have to understand each and every type of tables and graph. Then here, our one of the fundamental thing we have to put, or we have to understand, to know the better way in tables, graphs, and diagrams based DI caselet, first we should understand how many type of tables and graphs are there which are frequently using for CAT purposes. Then just continue to learn at the rate of www.paroliko.com, or you can download the mobile app also. Then remaining type of DI caselet, you will be able to learn in each and every type of DI caselet what are the tools you will be able to develop, either mathematical or logical. That is going to help to solve any level of questions. Then just thank you. Continue to learn.